he's every day of the week for me. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Psalms 42 and 8. Again, David said, my prayer is unto the God of my life. You know, prayer becomes hard when he's not your life. If you're trying to carry on a conversation with somebody you've not really surrendered to, prayer becomes difficult. 1 John chapter 1, verses 7, the Bible declares the word of the Lord that if we walk in the light, even as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another, and the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanses us from our sin. Some will say the blood cleanses. The blood of Jesus cleanses. For example, you can do me wrong, and I can make a choice to forgive you, but I can't cleanse you from the wrong you did, though I forgive you. Jesus not only has the power to forgive you for what you've done, but he has the power to cleanse, make you another person, change you, convert you, turn you inside out. Someone say that's what a miracle is. Mess turned inside out. I don't know about you, but he got me, he got hold of a mess. Amen. But it's a hey, gentlemen, now there's a message. Come on, somebody.
Second one, amen.
same. Some can pew harp on Sunday morning, but by Monday afternoon they whore harp. Come on. Yeah, I'm a preacher. Hallelujah. Come on. Hallelujah. Amen. God's just a day to them, or a few hours in the a.m. of Sunday. Praise God. But when he's your life, come on, church. That means you don't just serve him a little day to do. Amen. When it's church time, glory to God, he's your life. You live for him every day, every moment, every second.
Surrender, amen, to this Christ of this cross. Praise God.
Passover. And that's what they were coming to remind themselves of. Amen. As they ate this meal, and Jesus was about to reveal to them in just even a few days, or during this moment, not a few days, in a few hours, that he was the Passover. Because 1 Corinthians 5:7 says, Christ our Passover has been sacrificed for us. He was going to take the wine and say, this is my blood. He was going to take the bread, break it, because his body was the bread that was going to be broke. And then he blessed it and said, take ye, eat and drink ye all of it. Glory to God. Amen. We call it the Lord's Supper, the Last Supper. Praise God, but it was the Passover meal. Amen. And Jesus was saying, I am the fulfillment of what God instituted for Moses in Exodus 12. I am the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. You know, in John chapter 6, some of his followers, his disciples, couldn't handle this message because in verse 54, he told them, unless you drink my blood and eat my flesh, you'll not have everlasting life. They thought he was preaching cannibalism. Hello? But he was speaking things of the Spirit. He was letting them know, I'm the Lamb that was sent from heaven, and I'm about to shed my blood, and my body's going to be broken. Hallelujah. By my stripes you're healed. 1 Peter 3:5. Praise God. He said, I'm about to become the sacrificial Lamb of God, whose blood is sinless and pure. And except you receive what I'm about to do on the cross, glory to God, you won't have eternal life. Buddha can't save you. Allah can't save you. Come on, somebody. Church membership can't save you.
Some things ain't gonna happen. So sad about it in Matthew 27:36. It said that these Roman soldiers
watching. And you're no longer moved. Man, that's a picture, sad to say, of a little more modern Christianity. Where people just cut, they're no longer moved. They're no longer moved by the message of the cross. They're no longer moved by the blood of Christ shed his blood for their sins. Amazing grace don't cause a tear to run down their cheek no more.
This was the setting. These Greeks were here to worship.